Hi, I am Dr. Naman Shastri, Chief Consultant Cardiac Anesthesiologist, Epic Hospital, Ahmedabad. I'm taking care of Anesthesia Department of Cardiac Anesthesia and Intensive Care. Many patients, when they are kept on mechanical ventilations, maybe because of the acute lung injury, and when these patients end up into the acute lung injury, it is very important the way we ventilate these patients, because if our mode of ventilation is not proper in such cases, then these patients can have the further harm by ventilator itself. So very important to see that which way we are ventilating to the patient having already acute lung injury. FRC, that is a functional residual capacity tool, is a tool which quantifies the loss of the volume. The quantification of the mass of a lung which is lost because of the acute injury. So how does it do it? It goes by the nitrogen washout technology. So basically, it is the functional residual capacity is the amount of the air remain in the lung after the end of exhalations. Now it can be measured in a spontaneously ventilating patients, but very difficult to measure when the patient is on intubated conditions. So in that, the technology developed to measure this technology is by having the nitrogen washout. So by keeping the patient on the steady state with a baseline oxygens, the nitrogen admixture of a gas is measured by subtracting the fraction of the oxygen and carbon dioxide. And by increasing the 10% of oxygen in this pre-existing steady state, we measure the nitrogen and nitrogen washout, and the end of the exhalations, whatever the amount of the air left can be measured by the tool, what is called a functional residual capacity measurement tool. So what is the advantage? Why do we measure this? It measures because that gives an idea about the whatever the amount left into the lung after end exhalations. If it is going down, that suggests that patient is having a losing lung masses, lung volume. If FRC is increasing, oxygenation is increasing, recruitment of the alveoli is increasing, that again suggests that patient's more alveoli, more lung has been started recruiting. So continuous measurement of FRC by the respiratory model, that is the module available with the machine which has to be fitted into the patients. They measure the oxygen, they measure the carbon dioxide, they measure the nitrogen, and they give us an idea about the FRC. Some example, one patient who had a Guillain-Barré syndrome, been ventilated. When we tried to extubate that patient, after extubations, patient had stridor. We had again to reintubate the patients, and patient was maintained with the 5-15 pressure support with the 5P. Over a period of time, patient got stable, but when we measure the FRC was reducing from 1100 to 900 ml. The requirement of a peak increased to maintain the saturations, which has dropped down to 90% from 90%. We kept on increasing the peak to increase the FRC, but beyond, even by increasing the 20 cm of water pressure of a peak, the FRC could not really go up more than 1100 ml. And when we look at the X-ray, there was a big volume of a lung which was lost because of the lot of infiltrations, acute lung injuries. And then we had sent for the cultures, patient got MRS positive. Then what we realized to maximize the FRC by optimize the PEEP value. In PEEP in view, what it does, it measures the FRC, and for having optimum FRC, what level of the optimum PEEP is required to the patients, that also measured. So it should not happen that we keep on increasing the PEEP and we harm the patients. So PEEP in view can also identify the exact amount of the PEEP required to obtain the maximum FRC, and balancing in that, it can give us what is an ideal ventilation for the patients. By managing this, we optimize the PEEP, we optimize the FRC, we manage the patients, and we found that patient's FRC went up from the 900 to 1100 to 1500, and kept on maintaining above 1600 when we extubate it. So the FRC and peep in view is very important tool which can give us an idea about the ideal ventilations to this patients. Over and above, we can have the same respiratory module, we can have the metabolic monitoring, which can give an idea how much energy is consumed by the patients in this status by the catabolic states, and we can supplement the requirement of energy to the patient. Even we can measure the VO2 max, the oxygen consumptions at the end of exhalations by this technology. So by this way, we are not managing only oxygenation, but the ideal way of oxygenating the patients with the ideal requirements of the metabolic status and ideal requirements of the oxygen consumption supplementations. All these things comes into this module. So this is one of the few good important modules, and the data has correlated very well with the CT images also. So what we do routinely in our patients, and when patients stuck up on the ventilation for the long time, we implement that on these modules to save the patients.